Hey everyone, this is Jack Dre speaking to you from that glorious vacation paradise, Miami Beach, Florida. Here at the Miami Beach Auditorium, where another record-breaking season is being highlighted tonight by this 15-round battle for the lightweight championship of the world, bringing together the former champion, Wallace Smith of Cincinnati, Ohio, going against the man in the return match to whom he lost the title, Joe Brown of New Orleans, Louisiana. They're ready to go in the center of the ring, and here's the ring announcer, Art Nierstedt.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The officials assigned here this evening by your Miami Beach Boxing Commission, the official timekeeper, Al Sherman, at the bell, counting for the knockdowns, Jim Ruby. Judges are Stu Winston, Eddie Fall, and your referee for this contest, Jimmy Peerless. Your commission physicians attending the boys, Doctors Alexander Robbins and Dr. Samuel Kaplan. We have a few pugilistic lights gathered here this evening. A young man who you will see here next Tuesday night, light heavyweight Clarence Hinnant. Middleweight prospect Jimmy Beecher. Former lightweight champion of the world, Bo Jack. Also, ladies and gentlemen, the former middleweight champion of the world, Ray Robinson. Last but not least, the former light heavyweight champion of the world, Joe Maxwell. Ladies and gentlemen, this is an international boxing club lightweight championship contest. James J. Norris, president, Chris Dundee, your promoter. The main event is a 15 rounds for the lightweight championship of the world. From New Orleans, weighing 134¾ pounds, wearing white and black trunks, the champion, Joe Brown. And the challenger, the ex-champion of the world, weighing 134, now making East Orange, New Jersey, his home, wearing the black trunks, Wallace Smith. 15 rounds.
Fellas, you received your instructions from the Miami Beach Boxing Commission this afternoon. I'm here to enforce them laws. The 8-pound law is waived. And I tell you to break clean and watch yourself at all times. Shake hands now and come out fighting. Good luck to both of you.
As the referee, Jimmy Peerless, with his reminder instructions to the fighters, if you're scoring tonight's fight, the 10-point must system is used here in Miami Beach, Florida. 10-point must. 10 points to the winner of a round, a lesser number to the loser. If the round is even, each fighter gets 10 points. Round number one. In the white trunks, Joe Brown. In the black, Wallace Smith. Brown, the defending champion. This, the return bout after Brown lifted the title from Smith last August. Smith in the white trunks, equipped with a very fine left hand, his left hook is most powerful punch. Both these boys have a pretty impressive knockout record, particularly considering the fact they are in the lightweight division, where there isn't a great deal of beef behind a punch. Joe Brown, in 59 victories, has scored 25 of them by knockout. Wallace Smith has scored 18 out of 32 victories by a knockout.
Get into it, Brown has been keeping busy with that jab, potting away at Smith, who likes to move in on his opponent. It's been keeping Smith at a distance. That hook, however, did even better than that. It was a good hook landing on Wallace Smith. Smith has had practically no success after he won the lightweight championship from Jimmy Carter. We've got a minute to go in round number one. Smith is in the black trunks. He is now working on a losing streak of four straight. Two of those losses coming to this boy, Joe Brown in the white trunks, who he's fighting tonight. And Brown now is getting some good pot shots in at the head of Smith. Seconds left in this first round. To the second round of the scheduled 15-rounder between champion Joe Brown and the white trunks against Wallace Smith for the lightweight championship of the world. Of a knockdown, this being a championship bout, the compulsory eight count is waived. Fighter can resume as quickly as he cares to. Beautiful right cross banged home by Joe Brown. From Smith's corner, we can hear shouts of his seconds calling on him to move in. He has a little disadvantage in the reach against Joe Brown. Staying at long range adds to that advantage. There's a minute left in the second round. Smith gets home a good right-hand shot to the jaw of Joe Brown. He is finding Brown, however, a highly elusive target, as you can see quite easily. Brown with that big right hand again, and Smith is very wobbly. And the bell just comes home to save him in the round. Take a look into the corner of this champion, Joe Brown, whose big right hand almost dropped Wallace Smith at the end of the second round. He won the title from Smith last August. He's heavily favored to repeat tonight because in that hand, he hurt his hand in the second round. Turned out he broke it. Hurt it again and perhaps actually caused the fracture when he floored Smith with it twice in the 14th. The reasoning being that if he could do that with a bad hand, he ought to be a cinch when the hand is well. He has not fought since, as he's given that hand plenty of time to come around and has shown no tendency to favor it whatsoever in his workouts leading up to this defense of his title.